Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Political Life 5th Annual Future of Food and Farming Summit. My name is Zosia Vanat, and I am a reporter at Politico and also one of the moderators at today's event. Europe's agri-food sector was one of many affected by the knock-on effects of the last year pandemic. Today, we are checking in with the policymakers, the farmers, the industry leaders to see how the sector is bouncing back from that experience. We will be also keeping an eye on other burning issues such as the climate change, trade relations, animal welfare, and many more. We are thrilled to have this opportunity to welcome you both on site here in Paris, as well as online. And we hope that you will enjoy the conversations that will take place throughout these 2 days. We will deep dive into the hot topics both in Brussels and beyond with interviews and panel debates on issues such as the Common Agricultural Policy, gene editing, and the future of European farming, and many, many more. Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to thank our leading partner, Bayer, as well as our presenting partner, Herbalife Nutrition, for making this event possible. Before we start the actual debate, I would like to share some housekeeping rules with you. So you can ask questions and take part in the polls before some of the panels via our Swapcard platform. So if you join us online and if you join us via the computer, you will see a small question box on the right side of your screen, and you can ask your question there. If you are using your mobile phone, then you have to scroll down below the live stream section. If you are with us on site, you can do exactly the same thing. We left you the flyers with all the information, so you can just have a look there if you need any further instructions. As always, we would like this event to be as interactive as possible, so please don't hesitate to tweet about it. And our hashtag is Politico Agri-Food, as every year. So now, when we are done with all the housekeeping and logistic rules, this is my great pleasure to kick off this year's summit by introducing our first guest, a person who is in the very heart of the European agriculture, EU Agriculture Commissioner Janusz Wojciechowski. Dzień dobry, panie komisarzu.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the invitation. I'm ready for the meeting. Thank you.
Unfortunately, we can't have this conversation in Polish, which is a shame for me, but probably better for everyone else here in the room and online. So let's start. You know, Commissioner, happy EU Organics Day. You announced the EU Organics Day this very morning. So we know now that the 23rd of September is not only the political summit day, not only the UN Food Systems Summit Day, but also the EU Organics Day. Can you tell us, because maybe some of us have missed it this morning, can you tell us what is it about? Like, what is this Organics Day all about?
I'm very happy that we signed the joint declaration between European Commission, European Council, and European Parliament to establish this the 23rd of September as a European Union Organic Day. Proposed this idea in our Organic Farming Action Plan, and very briefly this idea was concretely implemented. That I'm happy that European Parliament, European Council decided to sign joint declaration. And today we signed this declaration with participation of all the most important actors. They was a representation of the COPA COGECA, which representing the all sectors of the European agriculture, CEJA representing young farmers, the IFOAM, which is representing organic farmers and producers, the Food and Drink Europe representing processing industry, Eurocommerce representing the distribution sector, retailers, BIUC organization, consumers organization, and also animal welfare in Eurogroup. The all important sectors, all important actors were represented, and my satisfaction is that they all these actors fully supported the idea, not only idea, the Organic Day, which we will celebrate in the future every 23rd of September, but that they support the idea to increase, to develop organic food production, and this very important target of the Farm to Fork and biodiversity strategy, which is to achieve the 25% of the agricultural land under organic farming, organic management to 2030. This is a very ambitious challenge. But after the reaction of our partners, very important partners, also including the Economic Social Committee and the Committee of Regions, who are also interested very much to develop the organic production, I'm very more optimistic that this target, 25% under organic farming, is achievable. That we achieve this target in 2030 with participation of all important actors, not only farmers, because there is a complex plan to develop organic farming, but also to develop processing industry, manufacturing, to develop the public demand for the organic products. Good day for the historic day for the development of the organic farming in European Union.
Concrete plans in this declaration, and are there any like concrete steps that all those actors that you've mentioned here will take, like anything that we can hold them accountable later?
Include the development of the organic farming into the national strategic plans. We are in the crucial time for this, to the end of the year. The member states are obliged to present their strategic plans for the Commission approval, and that is we sent before the recommendations to the member states, and the organic farming is very important target, and we are expecting that member states will propose an ambitious plan to develop the organic farming, especially in the member states in which the development of the organic farming is very small. We have the leaders in European Union like Austria, which achieved this target in the past. They have more than 25% land, agricultural land under organic farming. They are other countries which are close to the 20%, the like Italy, very well developed this organic sector and the success story for the farmers. But they are member states, unfortunately, my home country, Poland, in which is between 3 and 4% agricultural land under organic management. And we expect from this country the good proposal for the farmers, the good incentives for the farmers. We propose the interesting tools, interesting incentives for the farmers, including for example, the organic farming can be treated as one of the eco schemes, which is important, which are important part of the first pillar, direct payment system. We will also support the organic production from the second pillar of the Common Agricultural Policy. There is a lot of possibilities. I hope that the member states will be ambitious enough, and they will demonstrate how they increase the organic farming in the future. But there is positive reaction also the Today, in the celebration participated the president of the council, Mr. Podgorszek, the Slovenian minister of agriculture representing council. This is the common support for this idea to increase organic farming. No, nobody is against, nobody opposite of this idea. Now our challenge is to introduce this into the strategic plans. One additional sentence that first of all, this is the very good offer for the small and medium-sized farmers. We have many farms in European Union which are too small for the competition with the large-scale industrial farming. But if they decide to be the organic farms, the organic farmers, with support of the union, with strong support from the union, they not only can exist in the future, but they can develop their production. There is sometimes discussion about the organic farming and productivity of agriculture. In my point of view, that's the final balance of the effect of the organic farming for the productivity will be positive. Many farms which will stop their production in the future, they will continue the production. It will be the additional production for agriculture, but not only the production, but production of the good, healthy food produced in methods friendly for environment, for climate, for animal welfare. This is very important.
Commissioner, you mentioned two things that I think are quite important for our audience. And the first one is the adoption of the strategic plans, the Common Agricultural Policy national plans that the EU capitals will be sending to the Commission by the end of the year. I'm wondering, like you already said also to some of my colleagues that this is going to be a big political debate, that this is not going to be easy, that you as the Commission, you will have to check everything that is in these plans. What do you think will be the biggest challenge, and also what will you do, what can you do as the Commission to actually make sure that these plans contain what you want them to include?
No, first of all, now there is a difficult internal debate in the member states because the drafts of the strategic plans are presented to the public consultation. There is a lot of opinions, so not only from the farmers, from the public opinion. Everybody can send his opinion about the draft of the strategic plans. There is very large public consultations and. Of course, I know that I know the first proposal, the first drafts of the strategic plans, and I'm optimistic that the good common agricultural policy reform will be well implemented in the national strategic plans. But this is my first observation because I monitor. Of course, now I don't comment the draft of the strategic plans because it is not this time. We will do this when we receive the official versions of the strategic plans. But I am optimistic. What will be the great challenge? I think that there are some critical points. That's one of them. This is the redistributive payment. I'm very interested. What the member states they demonstrate to strengthen the support for the small and medium-sized family farms. In during one decade, we lost 4 million farms in the European Union. 4 million. It was 1,000 farms per day we lost in European Union. Now that this process is a little slower, and we need to stop this process. We need the role of the small and medium-sized farms is very important in the European agriculture, also for the food security. And I can say that's maybe not well known that now the leader of the gross value added in agriculture production, European leader, is Italy. which the highest added gross added value production in agriculture is Italy. 8% of the agricultural land in European Union, 18% of the production. And this is the success story achieved in model, especially the small farms, because the average size of the farm in Italy is 11 hectares. It shows that it is not necessary to have the large-scale farming, industrial farming to achieve the high level of productivity, food security. No, the small family farms, small, medium-sized, they play very important role. I think that what we should do is to better organize the cooperation between farmers, the processing industry, should be more synergy between the sector processing industry, also the system of distribution of food. This is the place for improvement. We can use also the good practices, short supply chain, development, the local market, the local processing industry. This is the area for improvement.
Commissioner, you mentioned several times the word productivity, and I think I know where it comes from. I mean, there's been quite a lot of debate recently about the impact of some of the policies you are responsible for, farm to fork policy, the European Green Deal in general, on European farming. There are the critics who say the Commission, I mean, there are some who say that there has been a study that says that it is like these policies are going to have a negative impact on the productivity of the European agriculture. I know that there is a problem with methodology, but the question is, are you going to assess it? Like, are you going to carry out the assessment of the Farm to Fork strategy and the European Green Deal on how these policies as a whole will impact the European farming and its productivity?
Thank you for this question. Yes, I use many times the word productivity because that is the main concern that and I can hear many times from the farmers, not only from the farmers, from the part of the public opinion, that there is a risk for productivity. There is a risk that we will will be negative impact for the food security in the European Union, because there is this direction to make our agriculture more friendly for environment, for climate, for animal welfare. The consequence will be the reduction of the production. Also, the study, GRC study, this is a very important document, but presenting some concerns. My interpretation is that there is a risk if we introduce these strategies in not correct way. There is a risk that we will lose productivity, but we are doing everything to avoid this risk. And for example, that I said about the organic farming, and there is a popular opinion that organic farming is less productive. Maybe that's this is possible in the conventional, in the intensive farming, from the concrete hectare to have more production, but many farms, the especially small and medium farms in the mountains areas, for example, this is only one choice for them: to produce organically and exist, or to try competition in the conventional production, and they have no chance, and they will be forced to stop their activity. This is one of the the positive impact for the productivity, organic farming. Eco scheme, which is the precision agriculture, very good offer also for the large scale farms to use the modern technologies, satellite technologies, to use the means like pesticides, fertilizer, very precisely in the place in which are needed. And we reduce the use of pesticides, fertilizer. They are targets, also the targets of the farm to fork strategy. But it can have positive impact for the productivity. That farmers know this technology. This is not new, that the farmers use this technology. But I don't agree with the opinion that farm to fork strategy, this is the strategy to reduce the food production in Europe. Not, this is not true.
Sorry, you know really well that there are the positive sides, but also the negative sides. And that's why the farmers say, and our other groups say, we need an assessment before we start implementing the policy. Will there be an assessment from the Commission?
This is the procedure of the assessment for when we each legislative proposal should be the this is obligation to prepare impact assessment, and we will proceed according to these rules. But the farm to fork strategy is the political strategy. It's, they are targets. This is not legally binding strategy. This is the politically, this is our common political obligation for our society. But also the farm to fork strategy is supported by the European Parliament, by the European Council, by the member states, and I'd like to mention one thing, that it was my contribution, special contribution to the farm to fork strategy, to add this obligation that we will monitor very carefully the impact during implementation of the strategies, impact for the food security. And if we will observe the negative impact, we will verify the strategy, also the targets of the strategy. But I'm not concerned that in my point of view, my vision, will not negative impact for the food security. But we need also to take into account a lot of expertise, a lot of analysis showing what will be the consequence if we don't introduce this farm to fork and biodiversity strategy. This race for the intensive, more and more intensive farming, it is the way which is going to the wrong direction.
Commissioner, so I will just sum up. So that means that you will carry out the impact assessment before every legislative file, but you won't, as the Commission, carry out the impact assessment of the farm to fork policy as a whole.
Yeah.
Okay. We are running out of time. I can't see any questions yet. So if anyone of you in the audience have a question, please ask it right now, because we still have 5 minutes. And Commissioner, one more topic I would like to address. Do you eat meat?
Not often, but I eat, yes. I'm not a vegetarian.
And are you trying to limit the meat consumption, or you're
organic,
happy
only
with
organic, organic, only organic. I'm okay. The consumer of the organic food, once again.
Of course. Of course. Organic, so you probably
meat very limited, but I'm the consumer of the organic food.
Oh, and of course, I mean
all consumers. But the problem is that the access to the organic food is not everywhere the same. Like, unfortunately, my home country Poland, this is the difficult to find the organic shops. But I know where are they, and I consume the organic food.
I will come for tips, because I can't find them yet. But you know why I'm asking this question. It's not because we want to know, you know, like, about your diet. It's I'm thinking about this policy about the subsidies for the promotion of EU agri-food. This policy is going to be reviewed this year. The result will come out at the beginning of next year. And there have been quite many concerns that the Commission is subsidizing the promotion of meat and dairy much more than, for example, vegetables and fruit. And you are in charge, as DG Agri, you are in charge of the review of this promotion, subsidy promotion policy. How do you think it will change? Will it change?
Yes, the promotion policy is very important for our agriculture. That the European Union has the highest standards in the world, the highest product production standards, sanitary, veterinary, animal welfare, which is the very, very close to my heart, that we have also the highest standards for animals. This is the reason that this is the good thing to promote the European food. They are I know the controversies about the promotion of the meat, but what is my approach now? First of all, our intention is to improve the animal welfare standards. This is the big plan. We propose a lot of new instruments. The animal welfare will be one of the eco schemes. We will encourage the farmers, incentivize the farmers to improve the animal welfare standards. That in the second pillar, I think that several times more money will be spent for the farmers who voluntarily improve the animal welfare standards. We cannot to say that we don't, positive effect will be also thanks to the promotion of the such production, sustainable. We promote only the sustainable, the meat which is produced in sustainable way with respect of the high level of the animal welfare standards. This is very important to achieve the real improvement of the animal welfare standards. For me, personally, I was at the European Parliament, head of the animal welfare intergroup, the promotion of sustainable meat production and from the farms, from the sector which is respecting the animal welfare standards. This is a very important part of this plan.
So do you think in this upcoming policy you could make like a condition that only the sustainably produced meat would get subsidies for promotion from the EU? Is that possible in your
view? Yes, but not only the promotion, the support for the production. I cannot to imagine to the future support for example for the industrial farming, livestock farming. No, we will support only the sustainable production and high level of the animal welfare standards. The very intensive industrial farming, this is not agriculture, this is the business, the industry. But we will support the farmers and the real farmers, they ensure the high level of the animal welfare standards. This is very important. I think that we will be able to demonstrate positive results of this policy at the end of this financial period, that we will achieve the real progress in animal welfare standards, the treatment of animals in European Union.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Commissioner. Unfortunately, our time is up. I think we've learned quite a lot about not only about your diet, but also about like the policy challenges in these months ahead. Thank you so much for joining us. It's been a real pleasure. And now we will slowly move to the next session, which will happen in 10 minutes. It will be a panel discussion in which we will deep dive into the topic of food labeling in the EU policy. So stay with us and see you in 10 minutes.